Welcome back to our video series to help you create a high converting Shopify store with PageFly. In today's video, you'll learn how to use the countdown timer element to add a little bit more urgency to your store. So we're here in the PageFly editor on a blank page. We'll come to the left toolbar and click add element and search for countdown. And once we find it, simply drag and drop it onto the page. So there's a few different parameters on the right hand toolbar to look out for. The countdown start can be a specific time or on the first visit, which means when someone opens your page and then goes to another tab, when they come back, the timer will still remain. On every visit, which means the countdown will start every time a new visitor visits your page or an old visitor comes back to the same page. But for now, I want to set it for a specific time. And that time will be today. And the option for countdown restart can be never, to run a one-off campaign, or it can restart every hour, day, week, or month. This is a very popular option for dropshippers. And for the countdown end, you can choose a specific time and date or a specific period. I'm going to choose a period and I'm going to set that to 3 days. And we can now see that the countdown has been activated. So there's also the option to redirect when the countdown ends. So you can choose to redirect to a specific page on your site or enter the URL. And we have the option to hide it when it becomes inactive so that people don't see a empty countdown timer when it ends. So some more parameters that you should pay attention to are the styling. So after selecting the timer, we can change things like the color, the margin and padding. We can add a background color or a background photo. And we can change the font size, the font family, and the width. Then if we come back to the general tab and we scroll down to more settings, we have some different parameters. So set full width allows you to take advantage of the whole page. You can choose to show the week as well. And you can change the labels, including the day, hours, and minutes, and seconds. Remove the colon or keep it, and remove the labels entirely. So now I'm going to adjust this and stylize a little bit in the styling tab to give you an idea of what it looks like. So after you've styled your countdown timer, click publish, and then live view to check it out in real time. And there we have it. That is how you use countdown timers with PageFly. Don't forget, if you need any help, you can reach us on our 24-hour support line within the PageFly dashboard.